New York.
Jason, thank you very much. And thank you so much for joining us tonight. I'm Kate Baldwin. Thanks. AC360 starts right now.
Good evening. We begin tonight with two big lies that got a dangerous boost over the weekend that only increased the threat this week to the Capitol. The familiar one that the 2020 presidential election was somehow rigged, and the more insidious lie that's been riding along with it from the beginning, claimed by people who should and probably do know better, that what we saw on January 6th, what you're seeing right there, and what they saw firsthand was actually not what it seemed, that somehow these Trump supporters, QAnon followers, and members of far-right militant groups were not responsible for the insurrection, and the other hidden forces actually were. Now, neither that lie nor the foundational election lie have any facts at all to support them. In fact, in addition, one lie contradicts the other. After all, the first is meant to justify what the pro-Trump insurrectionists did, and the second says they didn't actually do it. But despite being fundamentally incompatible, they're both designed to gaslight, to ask you to not believe what you saw with your own eyes, and they both have already stirred people to kill, which is why there's still tight security around the Capitol in advance of the March 4th date that many QAnon followers believe, bizarrely, will mark the return to power of the defeated 45th president. As for him, at this weekend's Conservative Political Action Conference in Orlando, he, of course, was back at it, spouting the election lie, trying to raise money, and using the same kind of language that incited the insurrection.